And here we are back on the I-53. Let's finish her off. So today we're going to paint up the deck. I did some research. The mounts for the katans or chitons were made out of not concrete, but something similar. So it was kind of this grayish stuff. I don't know exactly what it was, but it wasn't, it was an amalgamation. It was built into these sets and then mounted directly to the deck. And it even mounted over venting or stuff that was on the deck already. So it had to be removed easily. So what we're going to do is we're going to mask off the areas that don't need to be painted. Then we're going to paint the wood deck. We got a Japanese uniform tan coat color. We're going to get that painted, and then we're going to give it a wash, and then we're going to start staining the ship. We'll use Tiama Weathering Master. We got orange, silver, gunmetal, and we'll also be using soft pastels. So let's go ahead and get into the masking, painting, and just let's just truck on and see what we can do. Here we go. We'll be right back. here we are. We have finally finished the I-53. So, turned out pretty nice. Although these lockdowns for the chitin subs are of a really weird rubbery plastic that is very difficult to manage. Oh no, it's not a bad model. It's got some very rough fit issues. It goes together easily. There's not much information on the decals. I didn't find any instructions on where these go, but since there was a matching set for all five, I figured they had to go on the chitin. But I liked it. It's fun. It's a nice big project. And it was really enjoyable. I liked it. It was kind of something different. And it's big. That thing is huge. All right. Well, as always, like and subscribe. I appreciate everybody. And till next time, keep on modeling. I'll see you guys later, okay? Have a good one.